Hey, it's Frida K. I've been using the lymphedema pump for a while by the brand FlexiTouch by the company Tactile Medical. We're gonna see how long it takes now that I'm not a rookie. Some people had asked for an update. It makes me feel like a very cool YouTuber that people comment and ask for updates. I have lost a little bit of weight because I have been diagnosed as diabetic and I'm taking metformin. So my high weight was about 215 and I was probably right around there when I got the FlexiTouch. And we had some problems because the trunk piece was like right on the edge, like I was right in the middle of their measurements for sizing. So they actually wound up giving me another size. I can't remember if I started with a small one and they gave me the medium or whatever. But either way, I have two trunks now. And so whether I lose a little or gain a little, I should be fine now. I did wind up putting hair bands on each group of air hoses. Makes it a little bit easier. I bought a kind of a decorative dresser to use under the TV in this room so that I had drawer space, and that drawer space is devoted specifically just to pump garments. It's still a little huffy puffy to do this, but like anything, it's easier once you know what to expect. When my spouse is home, I'll get myself into it and then he'll tighten up my Velcros after I lay down, since the positioning change can, make it a little looser, a little tighter, but I can still manage on my own. He's at physical therapy for his shoulder right now, which is why I haven't been recording, because he's been home for like six and a half weeks. And so he's cleared to go back to work now on days that he doesn't have physical therapy. So that's how long it took me to set up. Next is the manual lymphatic drainage portion of the program, which you should do every time you pump. And they should send you to hopefully a CLT, which is a special certification that a physical therapy assistant or a physical therapist would have. And they teach you how to do it at home. It feels so much better when somebody else does it. Not gonna lie. I'm not saying I'm super good at this or anything, but I've been doing it a little while. Now, one thing that they always tell you is that, like, if you have a really good pumping session, that you'll probably wind up peeing a ton because the fluid makes it up to your kidneys. And then you pee it out. I don't have that experience. And my other doctors have warned me that if I were to start peeing massively after pumping, that I would have to be very careful because that might increase my dysautonomia symptoms. That has not happened thus far. I am wearing a sports bra. Usually I do this with no bra, but, you know, I don't want to be flapping in the wind on YouTube. But I wouldn't wear an underwire bra when you're doing it. This is the boring part. It's kind of uncomfortable. I did start out doing it in my recliner, and it is nice that the head goes back further on that, but just for convenience sake, having it all set up by the chaise is helpful. You gotta do your deep breaths because you have a channel that runs through your diaphragm. So they say hold your belly, make sure you're filling all the parts of it. So, I did take my husband to the MLD class to learn how to do this for me, but do you think even my very nice husband is interested in massaging me for an hour every night for the rest of my life? That's a hard no. So, getting the machine was great. I will say that out of all of the things that I have tried for dealing with lymphedema, the pump was the first thing that I felt a distinct amount of leg pain relief. The second thing that gave me a lot of leg pain relief and actually allowed me to decrease the frequency that I'm pumping is taking supplements called nattokinase and serrapeptase. The serrapeptase is the one that I started with. I just added nattokinase. Those are supposed to break up the fibrousness and make the fluid easier to move around. And I thought it sounded a little nonsensical, but it actually literally works. So anyway, I am ready to push the start button. That's all there was to it. And so my setup without me running my mouth is looking around like 5 minutes, and then you run the pump for an hour. I also have the arm portions. You can't run the arm portions at the same time because you run out of ports for your hoses to go into. So generally speaking, I would alternate. So I would do legs and trunk one day, arms another day. The arm routine is a lot longer. That's like a full ass movie. This one's just an hour for from your bra line down. So, always make sure you pee first. Always make sure that you have your glass of water or whatever ready, and your remote control, and that you already took your dogs out or whatever. Like, be ready to be settled in, because you don't want to stop partway through the routine, because the whole point of it being sequential is it starts here and it moves this fluid up, and then that has made some room, and then it goes here and it moves that fluid up, so now you have more room, and then here, and then here. And so you really kind of don't want to stop in the middle of that. So that's how it's going. What else is going on in life? Not a lot. We had our 20th wedding anniversary yesterday. We did nothing and went nowhere. We gave each other cards and gifts, but it was rainy, so we didn't do anything. My sister, Amy Living in Chrysalis on YouTube, is coming to visit today, tomorrow, something like that. I don't know. They're coming for probably, you know, a few days or a week. And then my daughter's visiting from Arizona. And then my stepdaughter and grandson are moving in with us. So I need to finish painting this room. You can see I got partway and then I pooped out. So there's just a really, really lot going on in May. But it's okay, it's all good. So I'm gonna turn you off so I don't kill all of my video storage. I'm gonna turn my pump on and I'm gonna watch something for an hour. I've also been trying to do my Spanish lessons while I'm pumping so that this time isn't completely lost to just like watching TV programming. And I think that helps. It's like, you know, oh, I'm gonna pump and study, you know? So far I can say, I'd like a different green shirt, please, in Spanish. So we'll see how that goes. I think I told you last time that, they put me on metformin for diabetes. It's horrible. It's horrible. I'm crapping myself all the time. I have such bad diarrhea. It's terrible. And it makes me nauseous and I don't want to eat. It's terrible. But because of that, I've lost some weight, but I'm like not even happy about it because who wants to lose weight that way? I've also had an increase in mestinon, which also has stomach upset stuff. So the two of them between them are killing me. But mestinon helps my brain work better, so you know, worth it. And I'm very runny nose because it's super pollen season, and you know, I have a gluten detection service dog, and he alerted on an allergy pill because I had him test my new meds, and then I was like, oh, as long as we're at it, we're working, we'll just run through the whole box. And just like an over-the-counter allergy daily kind of like Claritin knockoff kind of pill, he alerted hard on that. I was like, are you telling me I have been consuming a gluten-containing pill every single day for months because I didn't have my dog check my pill first? Ah, so I stopped taking it, but I haven't bought an alternative yet, and so it's just like sneezing and the nausea and the diarrhea. Like it's been a time. It has been a time. And because I very most likely have Ehlers-Danlos, like I'm sprinting to the bathroom, but I'm sprinting on a foot that has a dislocated situation happening. Like it's like a comedy of errors, if you're old enough to remember that term. It's just funny. I don't know. 'Cause like I feel like I'm making strides in a good direction, but at the same time, like the things I'm dealing with are so ludicrous that I think very few people would look at it and go, "Oh yeah, that's an improvement in quality of life." It's so silly. My life is ridiculous. But it's good. I'm all the way vaccinated, so I'm going to be updating my training so that I can go back to substitute teaching in the special ed if I can get the diarrhea under control, because can't do that in special ed. Can't run to the bathroom 4 times in an hour. So, you know, we're getting there bit by bit. I'm hoping to get back in the classroom before the year ends, but if not, yeah, I should have myself sorted by fall. Why are you so dirty? Oh my God, you're filthy. Oh, his feet are just disgusting. Ugh. He loves digging in the spring. Okay, so I hope you are having a better time than I am. But you know, we'll get through it. We will. I mean, that's the thing. Like, nothing that's wrong with me is gonna kill me. It's just really goddamn inconvenient. So it's all good. Nothing but love. Gonna go pump. Hasta la vista.